Hello everyone, this is an informational video on phonemic intelligence, our intelligence enhancing educational technology that we've been teaching to children worldwide for the past 10 years. My name is Elaine Kueper. I'm the Global Director of Phonemic Intelligence, or what we call PI, and I'm here today with Dr. Baskaran Pillai, the founder of the PI technology. I've had fantastic results using PI in our educational initiatives in India for the past 10 years, but I have some questions on exactly how PI works. Dr. Pillai, how do sounds create intelligence or improve intelligence?
The term PI, phonemic intelligence, is self-explanatory. It explains that phonemes, sounds, carry intelligence. A phoneme means it's the smallest sound. For instance, the sounds that we use in phonemic intelligence are like A, E, I. They carry intelligence. Universally, sounds create intelligence. The birds use sounds to communicate, and insects, mammals, all animals and all life forms use, even non-life forms use sounds as a means of communicating intelligence. Meaning is embedded in sounds. If there is no meaning, then you cannot understand. And where is the meaning? The meaning is in the sounds. And what is meaning? Meaning is a matter of semantics. Is a matter of intelligence. And it allows you to comprehend, to understand. Now this theory that sound equals intelligence is a very ancient concept. Particularly in the Indian psycholinguistic tradition, you see that sound, which is sabdha, and meaning artha, are interrelated. At a phonemic level, at the very fundamental level, they are the building blocks of intelligence. So, about 5,000 years ago, or even before, the yogis were involved in trying to figure out how we understand what is intelligence and what is the relationship between intelligence and sounds. So I developed on this concept, which is psycholinguistics or sacred linguistics. It is in Sanskrit grammar. And six systems of Indian philosophy, they all deal with questions that we have not even started asking, like which comes first, a thought or a word? And if a word carries intelligence, what part of the word or sound? For instance, is a sound like pull and bull? There is only one difference between these two words. Pull is pulling, bull is an animal. And how a single variation of the sound P as P and B create a change in meaning. So they studied it about 10,000 years ago. So this is the origin of it, and then I just wanted to use the modern means to validate it. So I went to different institutions to study this. The last one that we used was Harvard Medical School, where we found that these sounds go and affect the learning centers in the brain. The sounds that we have studied are A, E, and I. The A sound creates a global activation. It's a technical term. It activates the entire brain and it is repeatable. And the device we used is fMRI, functional MRI. We find that case after case, there is global activation with the sound R. And the sound also creates a higher cognition, which is the latest finding in neuroscience. A higher cognition is attributed to the cerebellum area. We have expression, we have activation there in R. That's why we find in phonemic intelligence dramatic results within a couple of weeks of introduction of the technique.